So good afternoon to all students. As
गुड
we
आफ्टरनून.
discuss in previous two three lecture, we discuss orthographic projection. So orthographic projections, we know that in the problem there is a isometric view of a product, and from that view we have to make the orthographic projections. So orthographic projection, we can say that this is a 2D diagram from given isometric view. Okay, so here, but our actual aim or our fourth unit is not orthographic projection, it is sectional orthographic projection. Means we have to do the sections. So we already discussed sections in the section of the plane, where we cut the section in oblique plane, perpendicular to vertical plane, parallel to vertical plane, perpendicular to horizontal plane, and parallel to horizontal plane, and inclined to horizontal plane, and inclined to vertical plane. So these planes called section plane. So our fourth unit is based on sectional orthographic projection. But before I teach you sectional orthographic projection, we must know what is the orthographic projection. So previous two three lecture, which is based on the orthographic projection. So the main function is, or we can say the important point regarding the orthographic projection is, we always make the orthographic projection in first coordinate or first angle and third coordinate or third angle. Okay, so as this diagram shown, this is our product. This is our product. And from this product, what happened? This is our section plane. This one is our section plane. So by this section plane, we cut the object vertically. Okay. We cut the object vertically. So what happened here? If we look from here, means this direction, these are without section and these two are with section. Okay, this is the standard view, means without section, and here is full section view, means we get the full section. And what is this hatched line? This line, the symbols that the section is cut. So see this arrow represent with this line. So this is the cutting edge. Okay, so here we can go through the how to cut the section. Sorry, how cut the solid by a given section plane. So why sectional orthographic projection are used? First things. So to understand inner detail of a complex object, because without cutting, we don't know what is the inside of the object or component. So some complex geometry is there, so that from these complex geometry, we have to know the internal dimension or internal design of the component, so we can understand what is the inner detail of complex geometry. So we need to cut the object. We need to cut the object. So when the object is complex from inside, there will be many hidden lines in the projection, and it will be difficult to understand the orthographic projection. Therefore, to understand the detail of complex object, sectional orthographic projection are used. Second point, to understand the material of objects. So if object is made of two or more materials, then it can be understood clearly by section of the orthographic projection. Okay, so if material, multi material used for the making the object, so by the section we can know about the material details. Orthographic projection of complex object are drawn after imaging it as an object cut by an imaginary plane or cutting plane parallel to principal plane passing through the detail of the object. An imaginary plane by which the object is cut, known as cutting plane or section plane. Okay, so plane by which cut the object, that plane known as cutting plane or the section plane. Portion of the object between cutting plane and the observer imagine to be removed from and then object is viewed by the observer and projection is drawn. Projection of cut object is known as sectional view or sectional projection. So generally hidden line are not drawn in the sectional view, because hidden line can be removed by the sectioning of the product, and we want to know what are the hidden lines observation by cutting the object. So there is no hidden line in the sectional view. In sectional view, the shape of the section, visual edges and contours of object behind the section plane are drawn. When one view is drawn sectionally, other view are drawn as if the object is not cut and the object exists as a whole. Okay. It means other view are not affected by the taking section in the one view, but cutting plane is shown in the non-section view to locate the section plane, and arrow are drawn to the show the direction of the site. So this is our section plane representation of our section plane. So what we can say, arrow is downward. So this arrow which is downward show that this is the direction of the cut. Cutting plane line is also known as line of the section or trace of the cutting plane. So here the portion of the object cut by cutting plane and touching the cutting plane is shown by the drawing hatches or section line of them. So we have to make the hatches in the cutting area of the product. Hatching or section line are drawn thinner than object line. Okay. Normally hatches or section line are drawn at 45 degree angle. Hatches line are evenly spaced at about 2 to 3 meters apart. Means between two hatches line there is 2 or 3 mm distance. Now see this, there is a cylinder and we can cut the plane cut the object by a plane which is parallel to the horizontal plane. An observer is there. Here is our observer. So after cutting the plane or after cutting this object, so this is our hatches line. Because there are the material, there are no material in between there and no material cut here. So what material is cut here? This much and this much thickness material is cut. See, after cutting. And why this hatches is there? Because this is the impression of the cutting tool. Impression of the cutting tool on the material. So these hatches line we show that the impression of the cutting tool on the particular object. Portion between observer and plane, upper half portion, is imaging to remove. So this portion is removed. Now this portion is remaining. So what happened? We can get the thickness. And what happened here? See, we look forward in x direction. So what happened? X direction no cutting sheen is allowed, only cutting plane is visible on the front view. So we can say that the front view is unaffected from the cutting of the plane. Okay. Now section portion will be shown in the figure. True shape of the section portion will be seen in the top view. This is our top view, or we can say that this is our sectional top view. So in the sectional top view we can observe the true shape of the object. So various cutting plane or section plane. So here we can discuss cutting plane parallel to the principal plane. Cutting plane parallel to the principal plane. Cutting plane parallel to the principal horizontal plane. Cutting plane parallel to the profile plane. So it meaning the cutting plane parallel to the profile plane, it meaning that this plane is inclined or perpendicular to the both the plane, to the both the plane. Cutting plane parallel to the principal vertical plane. When an object is cut by a plane which is parallel to the vertical plane, the real or true shape of the section is observed in front view. In that condition, what happened? The cutting plane is parallel to the vertical plane, so we can see the true shape of the section in the front view. Section plane will be seen as a cutting plane line in the top view. Okay, so see like this. This is our cutting plane which is parallel to the vertical plane. And what happened here? This is our top view. In the top view, what we can observe? This is our cutting line. So cutting line is most important. That two things is there, cutting line and sectional view. Okay, so if our product or our object is cut through the a vertical plane which is parallel to the vertical plane, so we have get our sectional view on the front view, and sectional line, cutting plane or cutting plane line in the top view. See, this is vertical. So what happened? This is our top view and this is our front view. So we can observe this cutting sectional view on the top and the section line or section plane line in the top view. So there is our observer. Cutting plane parallel to the horizontal plane. Now, if this is come, so our previous example, this is the example where the cutting plane parallel to the horizontal plane. So what happened here? If the cutting plane is parallel to the horizontal plane, it means we get our sectional view in the sectional view at the top view and section cutting line in the front view. So see here, the real or true shape of the section is observed in the top view. Section plane will be seen as a cutting plane line in the front view, just opposite. Now see, we cut this object here. So what we can observe? This is our top view and this is our front view. So here we can observe the section line. Okay. Now cutting plane parallel to the profile plane. Cutting plane parallel to the profile plane. The real or true shape section is observed in the side view. Okay. The section plane will be appear as cutting plane in the top view. So see here, we can cut the object like this. So this is our section view. So what happened? This is our x direction, means front view direction. This is our top view direction and this is our side view direction. So we can observe the sectional view in the side view. So see here, you can observe this is our front view and this is our top view. So what we can observe, you can see this is the object and we can cut here. So see, this is our cut line or cut plane, and this is our side view where we can observe the sectional things is here. So sectional view we can observe in the side view. Now rule for the sectioning. So sectioning rule for the machine element like rivets, ribs, bevs, soft, pin, nut, bolt, washer, key, cutter, these are the machine component, or we can say that these are used to assemble the machine component. Okay. Whenever the cutting plane is passing through the above machine element, and if cutting plane is contain the axis of above machine element, then they are not sectioned. So understand this line. The cutting plane passing through the above machine element, and if the cutting plane contain the axis of the above machine element, so there is no section because these are the simple. Okay, so we don't need to see inside of that. So if the cutting plane is passing through the center, then there is not section view. However, when the cutting plane is cutting element perpendicular to the axis, above machine element, section is taken and the projection hatching line are drawn. If cut plane does not include axis, then these elements are hatches. So it is important that we don't cut the object by the axis. So see what happened here. This is our rivet joint. Okay, so we cut the rivet joint so that the cutting axis pass through the axis line. Cutting plane is passed through the axis line. So what happened? The rivet material is not shown the hatches line. This is wrong. Here the rivet section or rivet portion not hatches because there is no need to show this. So other material must be shown the cutting section, must be shown as the cutting section. So this is our correct option and this is our wrong option. So on the rivet we don't show the hatches line. So see the next example. Observe this component. So here what we can see, the hole is there and the hole is 30 mm deep. This rectangular hole is 30 mm deep. So this is 25 and this is 25. So total height is 50. Okay, so take just that assumption. So this is our center line. Sorry, this is not cut. This is our center line. So See, this is our tatti, which is shown by the dotted line, means this is our hidden line, which is not visible. So this is our x direction, and here this is our top view direction. So this is our top view. So in the top view, what happened? We can see this as a rectangle, and all the things is visible within two view only. So what happened next? We can cut by the section near, cut by the at the center. So what happened here? So these materials not hatches. See here, these materials not hashed out, only hashed out this material, this center, this center, this center. So axis material is not cut the out. So we can visual the hatches here only. This triangle is not take any hatches. Okay, so we can say that now you can observe that which portion we have to give the hatches and which portion we don't provide the hatches, except they are under the cutting, because they are passing to the axis. And see, no material cut here. And so we can get the sectional view. Similarly, go through this. So where is our cutting section? See, this is our cutting section. So in the x direction, we view the center line, and see, this is our cutting section. So by this we can cut the section, and here we can visual the things. Okay, so this is the our cutting section. Now one more example, see here. We change the cutting area. Now what happened? This rib is there. So we don't section the rib, because now our projection is changed and cutting plane is also changed. So we can see there are two planes visible in the x, and this is our top view, and this is our front view. Okay, so we can increase and see the hatches. The sectional or orthographic view is somehow easy to in comparison to the projection of solid and section of the solid. So rule for hatching, see what is the rule for hatching. Area of a metal or material cut by and section plane show by the hatching line is projected. It is educated by thin line normally at an angle of 45 to the axis or to the main outline, like this. This is 45 degree. if the axis of the boundary of the section at 45, then the vertical or horizontal hatched line are drawn. See here, 45 degree, 45 degree, then 45 degree, then 45 degree. Then what happened? We have to draw the hatched line like this. Okay. So third case, separated area of a section of a single component or hatches in the same manner. So hatching line on a second part adjusts to the first R at 45 degree, but in the opposite direction, hatching line of a third part adjacent to the first two drawn at 30 or 60 degree. Sometime spacing of pitch of the hatched line is vary to separate from the adjacent part. So here, what happened? See, this is 45 degree, this is 45 degree, and this area is D. So what happened? We can show the different hatches because there are the different material. So this is our different material, this is different material, and this section is different material, and this section is different material. So what happened? We can give the different hatching angle. So this is 60 degree, this is 45 degree, this is 45 degree, but in reverse direction, and D hatches on the 30 angle. So this, the angle is 30. Why we cause this? Because these different hatches is because of the different type of material. Because of the different type of the material. So we can say that hatching is also very much important. Hatching is also very much important